It is blueberry picking season here in Newfoundland. It was a little late coming, but they're out. And there's still quite a lot of unripe ones yet, so it's going to be a long season if the weather keeps up. We'll probably go into October for blueberry picking. So today I'm going to show you what I do after I pick my berries, how I clean them and store them and all that stuff. And I'm not showing you my secret spot. But these are the most delicious blueberries on the planet, wild Newfoundland blueberries. So we pick our berries in these 10-liter water jugs that I've cut the tops off, and it still has a handle on it, which makes it very nice for picking. A lot of people use beef buckets to pick their berries. And when I get home, I just simply pour them into a colander and manually pick through them. I don't like to wet or wash my berries. Now, you do have to be very careful about where you're picking your berries in the province, because the sides of the highways and the pole lines are often sprayed with toxic pesticides. And while the companies that do it try to tell you that it's not too bad, these are pesticides that are known and they're used because they are long-lasting in the environment. Some of them, like Tordon 101, which is a common one that's used, or Agent White, is known to persist for at least 7 to 10 years, and that's why they use it. And these are not a good place to pick your berries because they will have pesticide residues and they're not safe. Hopefully someday the companies will use manual brush cutting and stop destroying our natural habitat. But for now, as long as you make sure you're not right on the side of a highway or on a pole line, and you safely pick your berries in a clean area, you shouldn't need to wash them. We are actually quite lacking in essential nutrients these days because we're eating foods that are much too sterile. And we don't get the soil organisms that we need. So as long as you're picking in a nice clean spot, and no, I'm not revealing my secret blueberry picking spots. And as I'm picking them in the field, I try to pick them as clean as possible. Now, our previous favorite picking spot got raked out by people using rakes. This is another thing I absolutely can't stand. And I think it's greedy if you're going to go out and use a rake, because you wouldn't believe the damage that it causes to the plants. A good 75% of the plants last year were destroyed. And when we went back this year, there's nothing left to the plants. They're just scrubby brush because whoever was in raking with the commercial rakes ripped everything off, including the leaves. And they also take the unripe berries, which if you're hand picking, you can leave the unripe berries so that they will ripen up and there will be food for the wildlife and for future people who are picking berries. So please don't use rakes unless you have arthritis in your hands and you're an elderly person and you want to be out picking a few berries. Maybe then a rake would be beneficial, but a lot of these people who are raking, and I call it raping, the blueberry bushes, are doing it to sell them. And in all honesty, because of that, I think we should have a ban on raking, or at least a limitation on raking, because with developments going in, a lot of the blueberry fields are being destroyed for that reason. And you know, this is one of our valuable resources that people have a right to go in and pick. So that was my little rant about raking and pesticides. But if you find a nice place and you hand pick carefully while you're out in the field, if I find one that I happen to pick that wasn't quite ripe, I'll just toss it back down on the ground for the wildlife or to reseed. And then you shouldn't have much cleaning to do. So I just put them in the colander like this and pick through them. Give them a few tosses, which gets extra dust or pollen off. As I'm going around, and it circulates the berries so I can get the ones from the bottom up to the top. And once I've completed all that, I will simply package them up and freeze them. There is no need to wash them or wet them. If you feel that you absolutely want to wash these berries, then you're going to have to lay them out on a freezer pan. Ooh, look at that big one. And then freeze them first before putting them in containers, or they will stick together. But if you do it this way, you don't have to worry about them sticking together. You can put them directly into your containers and into the freezer, so you can have blueberries all winter long. I like to have them pretty much every night in a smoothie. And I also make jam as needed. I don't generally bottle up a pile of jam. I'll just take out some frozen berries, pop them in a pan, simmer them down with a small bit of sugar. And you don't even need sugar, really. You just got to simmer them a little longer. And I can link to my jam recipes in the description box below. I've made jam for years and years and never used anything other than berries and sugar. So you don't really need a bunch of stuff like Certo and gelatin and other citric acid, which is generally genetically modified from mold. So why add those things to your great fresh wild blueberries? And as we've been picking blueberries, it's also chanterelle season, so we've been getting a few chanterelles. I personally don't like them, but my husband do, so he's been having some chanterelle omelets in the morning. Alright, so once they're picked through like that, then I simply take some yogurt containers, and we collected these a good few years ago, and I've been using them every year ever since. I don't eat yogurt anymore, but we kept all the containers, and they're good for reusing. And make sure your hands are clean. However, you know, you probably don't want to have lotions or anything like that on your hands. Just clean with some Castile soap and water, or even a little lemon juice on a napkin. And that's it. So now I'll go ahead and finish packaging all these up and put them down in a deep freeze, and they'll be good all winter long until next blueberry picking season. So what I have down here actually is two small deep freezes. I did have a large upright deep freeze, which is right here, and I found that it burned a lot of electricity, and it was you open the door and it lets a lot of air in, and things would get frostbitten. Also, if the power goes out, I want to have the smallest deep freeze here for my meats, so that we can run this off the generator and make sure we don't get spoilage. Whereas the one I have for other things like berries and maybe some my husband's bread and things that won't spoil if they thaw out, we have in this deep freeze here, and that way if we have a power outage or something like that, it doesn't really matter if they do thaw out. It's not going to make a big difference. So here is our haul of berries for this year, and we've circulated some. We still had some left over from last year, and we circulated those up to the top, and I have room for a couple of more containers, and we're done. So now I have a freezer full of berries anytime I want some berries. They stayed. These ones are already frozen, so I'll take one out and show you. They are not stuck together. So here they are, they're not stuck together, and we can just take them out and use them as we need them. So that's it, that's how I harvest and clean and store my berries for the winter, and just make sure they're picked in a clean spot, and there's no need to wash them, just place them in little tubs and into your deep freeze, and you have berries all year round. So I hope you enjoyed. I'll get back to cleaning up the rest of these berries and getting them ready to freeze for the winter. And of course, you got to pick out the biggest ones and eat them right now. Look at those. There's nothing like it. Fresh, wild Newfoundland blueberries.